All right, now let's quickly go back once again to that one piece of news that the entire cricketing world has been talking about for the last 2 days or so. And one thing that has become very clear is that from the 1990s to now, curbing corruption in the game has become progressively tougher.
In 1994, Shane Warne and Mark Waugh admitted they had received money from an Indian bookmaker called John for pitch and weather information. Next year, the Australian board fined both players double the amount they took, but it took 3 years for this hushed-up news to come out in the public domain. It was testimonies from Warne and Waugh that saw former Pakistani captain Salim Malik become the first cricketer to be banned for life for trying to fix matches. The two Aussies said Malik had offered them money to bowl badly and lose the Karachi Test in 1994. But in October 2008, Malik managed to get his ban overturned. The biggest and the only match-fixing scandal to hit India was the one that saw Mohammad Azharuddin being slapped with a life ban. Ajay Sharma, who played for the country in one test match against the West Indies in 1989, was also banned for life. Manoj Prabhakar, who started the scandal when he accused others of match-fixing, was slapped with a 5-year ban for his involvement with bookmakers. Ajay Jadeja was also banned for 5 years by the BCCI, but the Delhi High Court quashed the ban in January 2003. This is what sparked off the Indian chapter of the fixing scandal. Hansi Cronje, the central figure in the biggest match-fixing scandal to hit international cricket, testified, naming Azhar as the man who introduced him to an Indian bookie. Cronje was found guilty by the King Commission for numerous acts of trying to manipulate results. A little over 2 years after being banned for life, Cronje was killed in an air crash, aged 32. But the spot-fixing scandal is the worst to hit the gentleman's game because for the first time, cricketers are facing jail terms. Salman Butt was the captain of the Pakistan team when he coerced Mohammad Asif and Amir to bowl no balls at pre-decided times after accepting corrupt payments from bookie Mazhar Majeed.